Because he knew that there are poor people in Madinatul Munawwara. When he wasn't close to the mercy for humanity, when he didn't know the character of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam, then he kept drinking. He didn't care about the people in Masjid Nabi Sharif. He didn't care about the poor people in Masjid Nabi Sharif. But when he embraced Islam, and when he understood that the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the message of mercy, the message of service to humanity, then he knew that one is sufficient for him. The rest is for other people. That is the message and the character of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. That is the mahabba of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. And this is how Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam conveyed the message of peace. As I said in the beginning, Ya Yuhannas, the first message of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the first khutbah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Masjid Nabi Sharif, in Madinatul Munawwara. What was it that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said? Afshu salam, spread peace. Wa at'imu ta'am, feed the hungry. وَسَلُّوا بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّاسِ النِّيَامِ, and wake up at night and pray and worship Allah Jalla wa Ala when people are asleep. And what is the benefit of that? تَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ بِالسَّلَامِ, with peace, without any difficulty you will enter Jannah. Subhanallah. And that is not only Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Remember, that is the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is the message of Ata'ur Rasul. Who is Ata'ur Rasul? Who is Ata'ur Rasul? Tell me, brothers. We are sitting in the gatherings of Chishtis. Who is Ata'ur Rasul? Khaja Gharib Nawaz. Khaja Gharib Nawaz. Ata'ur Rasul fil Hind. Khaja Gharib Nawaz rahmatullahi ta'ala. It's important that we understand the message of these Sufiya. Those people who truly benefited from the spiritual message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. What does Khaja Gharib Nawaz say? He says, a friend of Allah, a friend of Allah must have affection like the sun. When the sun rises, it is beneficial to all. A friend of Allah must have affection like the sun. When the sun rises, it is beneficial to all, irrespective of whether they are Muslims, Christians or Hindus. Subhanallah. That is the message of Khwaja Gharib Nawaz rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. Every member of Kanzul Huda is given a booklet. And in the first page of this booklet, you will find this message of Khaja Gharib Nawaz rahmatullahi ta'ala. Khaja Gharib Nawaz rahmatullahi ta'ala says, a friend of Allah must be generous like a river. The generosity of a friend of Allah should be like the generosity of a river. We all get water from the river to quench our thirst. It doesn't distinguish the good from the bad and a relation from a stranger. The way a river will not differentiate, a sinful person will come, and I will not give water to the sinful person. I will only give it to pious people. A Muslim will come and I will serve the Muslim, not a non-Muslim. No, a river will serve everyone. That is the message of Khaja Gharib Nawaz rahmatullahi ta'ala. Khaja Gharib Nawaz rahmatullahi ta'ala says, a friend of Allah must display hospitality like the earth. We are raised and cradled in its lap, and yet it is always under our feet. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Many lectures can be delivered on this one saying of Khaja Gharib Nawaz rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. Khaja Gharib Nawaz rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi says, there are four cardinal virtues of the individual self. The first thing, refraining from begging in the state of poverty. Refraining from begging in the state of poverty. And the second thing, showing the attitude of being well fed when feeling hungry. And the third thing, maintain cheerful in a time of sorrow. And befriending an enemy. Befriending an enemy. If you want to be a believer, a true believer, then befriend your enemies. That is the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is the message of Ata'ur Rasul fil Hind. Khaja Gharib Nawaz rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. Khaja Gharib Nawaz rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi says, a sin committed does not harm an individual so much as looking down upon one's own fellow human beings. Looking down upon people, humiliating people, abusing people. So-and-so is evil, he's bad, I'm better. He's sinful, he's a drunkard, he takes drugs, he's a criminal. This is what we say. Khaja Gharib Nawaz rahmatullahi ta'ala is saying, their sin will not harm them as much as your perception about them will harm you. Their sin will not harm them as much as how you think about them will harm you. A sin committed does not harm an individual so much as looking down upon one's own fellow human beings. This is the message of Khwaja Ghareeb Nawaz rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. And then finally, Khwaja Ghareeb Nawaz rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi says, the spiritual disciple deserves to be called a dervish only when he lives in the world with no self-interest. With no self-interest. This is how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam served humanity. This is how the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam served humanity. And this is how the Sahaba alayhim uridwan, the Ahlul Bayt al-Athar, and the true awliya'i kamaleen served the makhluk of Allahu Jalla wa Ala. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this is the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that we need to convey to everyone. That Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, the beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِنَّمَا بُعِسْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. The only purpose of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam coming to this dunya, إِنَّمَا, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I have only been sent to perfect noble character. To perfect noble character. That is the purpose of me coming to this dunya. إِنَّمَا. What is إِنَّمَا? إِنَّمَا is kalimatul hasr. Remember the lecture on hasr, mahsur, قصر مقصور عليه إنما أنا بشر مثلكم. Only I'm only a man like you, or I'm only like you in being a man. I'm only like you in being a man. Remember that lecture? إنما means only. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, I have only been sent to perfect noble character. That is my maqsad. That is why Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم came to this dunya. To teach us how to treat people. To teach us how to behave with people, to give us the best akhlaq. This is the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And we need to implement that. Unfortunately, we have failed to convey the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. We can't just talk about it. We need to show Islam. We can't deliver many lectures about Islam and expect a change. It won't happen like that. It doesn't happen with lectures only. We have to display it, we have to show it, show Islam. Our ancestors, pious ulama, salafus salihin, they talked less, they showed Islam through their character. And that is what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam did. And this is the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Something I said, which was very important in the title of Maqasidu Sharia, if you remember, Maqasidu Sharia, we've delivered detailed lectures on Maqasid, the higher objectives of Islam, the higher goals of Islam. Do you remember them? A detailed lecture last week, we delivered a detailed lecture in Urdu on Maqasidu Sharia. قُلْ تَعَالُوا أَتْلُ مَا حَرَّمَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَيْكُمْ أَلَّا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْءٍ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا أَوْلَادَكُمْ مِنْ إِمْلَاقٍ نَحْنُ نَرْزُقُكُمْ وَإِيَّاهُمْ وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الْفَوَاحِشَ مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا وَمَا بَطَنَ وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ ذَلِكُمْ وَصَّاكُمْ بِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا مَالَ الْيَتِيمِ إِلَّا بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ حَتَّى يَبْلُغَ أَشُدَّهُ. This is the Quranic verse, two verses of the Quran in which Allah Jalla wa Ala mentions five higher objectives of Islam. What is the first maqsad of Sharia? Hifzul Deen. Hifzul Deen. What's the first maqsad of Deen? First maqsad of Sharia? Hifzul Deen. Protection of one's religion. And I want to tell you, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave this message, this maqasid al-sharia, higher objectives of Islam, before anyone could imagine this principle of living life. This is something amazing given by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam 1400 years ago. You know, these things, these maqasid, today when we talk about protection of one's life, that every individual has a right, this is a right of people, that no one can take their life. Today it may seem common sense, but if you think back 1400 years ago, what was the state of the people at that time? You will be amazed, you will be surprised how Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam completely transmogrified the state of people. Those in that paganistic society, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam came and changed their lifestyle. And what was the first maqsad that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught to people? What was the first maqsad of Sharia? Protection of one's life. Your life is sacred. Your life is muqaddas. Protection of one's life. And the second maqsad, hifzuddin, protection of one's religion. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave this message. And the third, hifzul aql, protection of intellect and sanity. And fourth, protection, hifzul mal, protection of your property and your wealth. And the fifth, maqsad of Sharia, higher objectives of Sharia, higher goals of Sharia. What's the fifth one? protection of nasl, protection of nasl, hifzun nasl, protection of your progeny, your children, your ulad. This was the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. You know, you may think, yes, these rights are common. We all know about these rights. But if you look back, in tribal Arabia, with those people, those Bedouins, who had no knowledge of rights, there was no concept of rights in that time. The concept of protection of life, protection of progeny, protection of maal, there was no concept of this. This was non-existent in their time. They had no knowledge of this. Equality, every human is equal, we are all equal. They didn't know anything about this. For them, the Quraysh was superior. For them, in that time, the strong people had the right to kill the weak people. The rich had the right to take advantage of the poor. In that society, when taking protection of one's progeny, this was non-existent. It didn't exist in that time. A tribe which was stronger and superior could attack any tribe and take their children as slaves. They would bury their daughters alive. There was no concept of protection of progeny, protection of maal. If you belong to a stronger tribe, the Qurayshi could literally get away with murder if they attacked someone who was a non-Qurayshi. And that was common. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam transformed that society. And when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with this maqsad, the farewell khutbah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, what was it? Your maal is sacred. No one has the right to take your goods. Your property belongs to you. Your life belongs to you. You have the right to worship Allah Jalla wa Ala. Today when people talk about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam and the way they convey the message of Islam, alayyazu billah, you know, it surprises me. Why is it that we do not talk about the maqasid of Sharia? This is something. Today, if you study Thomas Jefferson, the person who actually wrote the United States Declaration of Independence in 1776, 4th of July, what did he say? What are the three necessary things, main things? What did he say? Life, liberty, and pursuit of happiness. Life, liberty, and pursuit of happiness. These three things, where have they come from? Do you know that? Where have they come from? The origin of that is Islam. That is the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And reality, inshallah, we will in the future lectures, we will tell you about this. How he was influenced by John Locke, who studied with an Orientalist. He is a famous sociologist. Students, they know who John Locke is. This guy was a student of an Orientalist who was a lecturer at Oxford University and who was a master of Islamic sciences. He was a master of Maqasid al-Sharia. And if you look at the link between them, it's very clear. It's very clear that these Maqasid of Sharia that we talk about today, the five major higher objectives of Sharia, what are they? Hifz of deen, protection of religion, protection of life, protection of intellect and sanity, protection of your maal, your wealth, your property, and protection of your progeny. If you sum them up, these five Maqasid of Sharia, they can be three. They can be three. What's the first one? Protection of life. Protection of life, protection of intellect, and protection of progeny, it comes under protection of life. Is that clear? Protection of progeny and intellect, if you have good living standards, then your intellect will be good. So what is protection of intellect? It comes under protection of life. And protection of progeny, it comes under protection of life. And the second thing, protection of religion. And the third thing, protection of one's property and wealth. And if you look at the United States Declaration of Independence, what are the three things? Life, liberty, and property. Life, liberty, and property. Initially, it was property and wealth, and then they later changed into pursuit of happiness. Originally, it was property. And there's a reason behind that, which I will mention in the forthcoming lectures, inshallah, why they changed it. Why they actually changed it into pursuit of happiness. And even today they say pursuit of happiness is property, wealth. If you have good wealth and good property, then you will have happiness in life. But in reality, there are three. And those of you who are students of history, you will know what liberty is. Liberty to the Christians, what was it? In 1776, what was liberty? What did liberty mean to them? It was protection of Christianity. It was freedom of worshipping the Lord the way they wanted to worship the Lord. That is what liberty was. So liberty was protection of deen. Now let's look at these three maqasid of Sharia. Maqasid of Sharia, mainly what are they? Three maqasid of Sharia. What's the first one? Hifzul nafs. What is it? Hifzul nafs is protection of life. And under that is protection of intellect and sanity and protection of progeny. Hifzul nafs, protection of life. And the second one, what's the second one? Hifzul deen, which is liberty. To the Christians at that time was liberty. And the third one is protection of property. These three are the maqasid of Sharia. These three of maqasid. Today the United States Declaration of Independence, what does he say? Three things. What are the three things? Life, liberty. And what's liberty? Protection of religion. And what's pursuit of happiness? Protection of property. And what does Islam say? Protection of life, protection of deen, and protection of everyone, property and wealth. They said this in 1766, 4th of July. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned this 1200 years before them in the streets of Madinah al-Munawwara. It comes from Islam. It comes from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And remember, I'm not only talking about Arabia. Even the medieval Europeans, they had no concept of equality. They didn't know what equality was. They had this belief. They had this belief that God Almighty has predetermined people and the status of people. They actually believed that the farmers had their position, the laborers had their position, the noblemen had their position, and they believed that the king is above the law. The laws of the land are not applicable upon the king because he is above. That's what their belief was. Who told the people, who taught humanity about equality? It is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. This is the lesson of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. And you can understand that under the title of Maqasid al-Sharia, the Maqasid of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Maqasid of Islam, the higher objectives of Islam. And these are only daruriyat. The daruriyat, then they are hajiyat and tahsiniyat and kamaliyat. We will discuss them inshallah in the future. This is the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The message of mahabba, the message of mercy. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught people what life was all about, what protection of life is, what protection of deen is, what protection of progeny is, what protection of intellect is. This comes from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam, the beloved of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now that we've talked about some beautiful incidents that took place in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam, and we've understood that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not only a mercy for Muslims, the beloved of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a mercy for every creation of Allah jalla wa ala. Muslims, non-Muslims, everyone. Now let's begin with the importance of Mawlid. Miladun Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Mawlid of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam.